Tom Clancy's The Division 2 can be pre-ordered as of a week ago. There are 6 editions you're able to pre-order, each with different pre-order bonuses. As this can be quite confusing, I'll break down the editions on screen to clearly show you the difference in the boxes and give you my opinion on the best edition. Keep in mind that these are pre-order bonuses, so if you're buying this when the game is already released, you might get other bonuses or none at all. Before we're starting with the overview of all the editions, we'll take a look at all the pre-order bonuses you can receive so you know what you're getting for each edition. After that, we'll show you what each edition brings to the table. The first bonus is the game, Tom Clancy's The Division 2. It's obviously rewarded in every edition. You'll be able to play the game and all the content that is included at release. The second bonus grants you access to the private beta, allowing you to play the game at a date that is yet to be announced. The third bonus, the Capital Defender Pack, is a collection of cosmetic items. It includes the Hazmat 2.0 suit and an exotic variant of the Spes 12 shotgun, the Lullaby, and its weapon blueprint. So that's right, the Spes 12 is coming to the Division 2, and I love that. It's an awesome shotgun. Every edition, but the Gold Steelbook edition, includes the Tommy the Teddy Bear ULC, assuming you're pre-ordering through the Ubi store, or in other words, it's PC exclusive. A ULC is a trophy that hangs off your backpack, so yeah, who doesn't want that, right? Good times to be a PC player. And when pre-ordering, you'll get 3 days early access, meaning you'll be able to play on March the 12th instead of the 15th. The Year 1 Pass comes with every edition but the standard one. While the 3 expansions that'll drop in the first year are free and available to everyone that owns the game, this pass will grant you 7 days early access to the expansions and exclusive access to bonus add-ons as well as activities. What these bonus add-ons are is unsure as of yet, but they'll probably be cosmetic unlocks like charms, masks, outfits and weapon skins. There will be even more that comes with the season pass, but they will reveal that at a later date. Some editions ship your game in a steelbook, a hardened case as opposed to the regular plastic one. Looks and feels a bit better, I guess, but it's mostly for show. This is only available on consoles, as on PC you'll get a download code. Besides that, the more expensive editions have 3 customization packs. The Battleworn Secret Service Pack, the First Responder Pack and the Elite Agent Pack. The Battleworn Secret Service Pack comes with a Secret Service outfit, exotic M4A1 weapon skin, so we're probably getting exotic weapon skins, and a rare quality emote. The First Responder Pack comes with an outfit and rare weapon skin. And finally, the Elite Agent Pack comes with the exotic AK-47 variant, Ruthless, a unique skill visual and additional stash space, which is pretty nice as well. Included in the more expensive editions, you will get the soundtrack for Tom Clancy's Division 2. This is a CD you get sent with all the in-game soundtracks on it. These same editions come with a copy of the Washington DC map, as well as a book of lithographs, aka the art of Tom Clancy's The Division 2, which is essentially just the art book similar to The Division 1. And finally, the 2 most expensive editions each come with a different statue. One comes with a Heather Ward statue, while the other one comes with a customizable, articulated figurine of Brian Johnson. Since those were all the pre-order bonuses, let's take a look at the editions and what bonuses they bring us. As mentioned, there are the Standard, Gold, Gold Steelbook, Ultimate, Dark Zone Definitive and Phoenix Shield editions for a total of 6 editions. Each one increasing its price as well as the bonuses rewarded. We'll be taking a look at them from the cheapest to the most expensive edition, starting with the Standard Edition. The Standard Edition comes with Tom Clancy The Division 2, access to the Private Beta and the Capital Defender Pack. The Beta Access and Capital Defender Pack are only included upon pre-ordering. If you're buying this when the game comes out, obviously you won't get them. This edition comes at the cost of the regular $60. This price may vary on where you live. The Gold Edition grants you the same bonuses as the Standard Edition, including the Tommy the Teddy Bear ULC, but this only applies if you buy it through the Ubi store, of course. You'll also get to play 3 days earlier at March 12th and gain the Year 1 Pass. This edition comes at the low cost of $100. Slightly more costly is the Gold Steelbook Edition. It comes with all the bonuses of the Gold Edition, except the Tommy the Teddy Bear you'll see, but instead it grants you the game in a steelbook case. This is only available on console since PC players receive a digital download. It adds $10 for a total price of $110. If you're looking for something a little more fancy, though not the most expensive one, the Ultimate Edition might be something for you. It comes with all the previous and adds the three customization packs, the Battleworn Secret Service, First Responder and Elite Agent packs. It only lacks the steelbook case, and with that it comes with a double price of the Standard Edition at $120. We're raising the stakes with the Dark Zone Definitive Edition, the second to last one that actually grants some bonuses outside of the game. It comes with all the previous, including a steelbook, as well as the game soundtrack, Washington DC map, the Tom Clancy Division art book or lithographs, and the Heather Ward statue, which is the Agent Flair statue. It does come with a lot of extra content, and that's going to cost ya. Over thrice the price of the Standard Edition, it comes in at a whopping $190. And finally, the end boss, the big boy, is the Phoenix Shield Edition. For those of you with more money than brains, it grants you access to all the previous extra content, except instead of the Heather Ward statue, you will get the Rian Johnson statue. An insane amount of content, but it comes at a price. And that price is $250. You can almost buy a kidney for that. Almost. Six editions and lots of choices to make. I like the content that they provide, although the price for the more expensive editions gets pretty insane, at least for me. I want to ask you, which edition are you most likely to pre-order, assuming you're pre-ordering at all? Since my channel revolves around Tom Clancy Division 1 and it will revolve around 2, I will get one of the more expensive editions because I'm using all the extra content for YouTube and I also have a personal interest in game arts. I'm currently stuck between choosing the Ultimate Edition and the Dark Zone Definitive Edition. I'm interested in the Washington DC map and the art book, but $180 is quite a price, so I'm not sure yet. I will let you know what I decide, but until then, let me know what you will pick and I will see you next time. Have a good day, treat yourself to something nice, and peace out.